When drawing the portrait, it's important to not think in symbols. Don't think about eyes, nose, mouth. Think instead in terms of a shape map, the light-dark pattern that becomes apparent when you squint your eyes down and look at the subject. Also think of the head as broken into halves. Let me show you. Top of the head, bottom of the chin. In the middle would be the eyes, approximately. In the middle of that, halfway down, would be the bottom of the nose, approximately. Halfway down from that point would be the mouth. So we have top of the head, bottom of the chin, halfway down, eyes. From that point to that point, halfway down, nose. From the nose to the chin, halfway down, mouth, approximately. You've already solved a lot of problems for yourself. I'm working on a toned paper here. That means that I have pre-toned it with charcoal dust and a chamois cloth, and that will help me get the shape map. I want to look for the dark shapes first. Here I go, squinting my eyes down. I think like a photocopy machine, and I want to see the light shape and the dark shape. Top of the head, there's a dark shape here. We have the eye sockets here, and they connect with the brow in this case. We come around. We have the plane of the nose. I'm looking for the edge of this light dark shape, this pattern. I'm just approximating it. I don't even want to know about likeness or think about likeness or anything like that right now. I'm just searching my way through that light dark shape. And then the chin and the jaw cast more. I'm connecting this light dark shape. Now, if I think about it this way, and I don't let myself think about it being a portrait, I'll come a lot closer to getting the form or the gestalt of the thing. I'm looking at the values or the tone only, and I'm trying to simplify it as much as possible into two values. Right now, middle value, which is the paper, and the dark value. It's helping me see the form. And there we have already something that looks sort of human. Now, I do say sort of. Now that I've sort of landed the head, if you will, I come across and begin to check that shape map, get a little more specific, and now I'm going to look inside the dark shape, which runs along here. This is the column of light that runs through here. And within it, I'll make a couple of notes about darker shapes within it. Just a couple of notes, just to make sure I'm on target here. Those dark eyebrows. Okay, it's looking better. Just a couple of notes that are darker yet. Now, I don't want to fool around too much with these details. So right away, I'm going to go through, and with a kneaded eraser, using it just like a drawing tool, I'm squinting my eyes down again, and I want to pick the lighter shapes out of the light side, leaving the middle tone. So I have a dark side, a light side. Now I'm going to look for the lighter shapes on top of the middle tone. Here is an obvious one, squinting my eyes down. Here across the brow a little bit, using less pressure, make it not too light. I'm modeling now, you see? Top of the brow, just modeling a little bit. Across this nose, there's down the bridge, fairly light. Here, just a little bit. Here in the mouth. And as you see these shapes, they help you correct the drawing. This is a bigger shape than what I'd originally stated. Here on the lip, there's a little cast shadow and light on top of that. And here across the cheekbone, a little bit of light as that bone protrudes and the flesh falls away. I'll make a little note with my kneaded eraser now about the edge of the jaw as the face turns back and hits the lobe of the ear there. Make a little note about that. Coming down. And then from the lip, if I come across, I see a collar kind of coming out. Make a note about that. That's a lighter note. Okay, now I've got my basic statement. If this is as far as I went with this, it would still be interesting. It would start to have form. Let's go in now and start to break up some of these things. Maybe with a linear shape, make a little note here. Just a note. I'm not drawing hair. I'm just making a note of it because I'm not really sure where it's to be placed. Just make a little note of that. Little note here, squinting my eyes down once again, going back into my photocopy mode, looking for shapes. Maybe I'll draw the shape just a little more carefully that goes through here. And then inside here, I'm just sort of searching through. I'm still not worried about, this is an exercise. I'm still not really worried about likeness at all. Again, kind of searching for where the collar might come out. Hood of the eye, the eyelid sets as a hood over the orb of the eye, actually. Kind of make a note of that. I don't want to get too fussy in here. Keep this kind of hooded and dark. Pick through here a little bit. And now I'm pushing the darks just a little bit further. Get some edges, start looking for the edges here. There's a big cast shadow here made by the eye sockets. So it puts the eyes back in little caves. And then I'm beginning to see that the background is darker than the ear, even on the dark side. So I'm going to go in there and use this negative space. Negative space is a good tool to describe that edge. And that'll be kind of fun. Doesn't have to be exact, just approximately. Now we've kind of got the bring the hair in a little bit. See how I'm working so broadly, the broad side here. We've got a little sphere of the cranium. And this is the way we want to go about just playfully doing a portrait, just playing at it, not worrying about whether it looks like the person or not. Initially, your study should just be playful, loose, looking for the form, and you'll end up with something a lot better, a lot more interesting anyway, than if you tried to draw features, symbols. Try not to think like that in terms of features and symbols. Look instead. See how I just went dark, dark, light, edge, line, jaw, but it's a line first, then it's a jaw. It's a dark shadow against a light mark. It's dark against light, comes down, then it becomes the collar. The viewer will see it that way. You don't need to think about it that way, though. Once you get the form established so that you can tell you're looking at something sort of human, then you can step back and start to appraise the proportions and maybe reestablish or correct some things. And so I'll stand back and just sort of look at the drawing and then come in and make adjustments. Sometimes it's things around the figure that can make changes. If we bring in here the background, sometimes that will make things about the figure look more finished. So here we are just putting in more background, just using fine charcoal. Once again, this just any old direction will do here. Just trying to get some material on there. We're vignetting here. Simply done. Give some energy to the thing. And you can take a chamois cloth and soften that so it doesn't have as active as look. Just soften that down. Some people call it blending, whatever. You can go in, fool around. This is where you get a little bit artistic with it. But the idea is to stay playful, relaxed.